देवतुल्य भाइयों, सिंस मॉर्निंग वी हैव एक्टिविटीज रनिंग ऑल ओवर एंड एक्चुअली आवर स्केड्यूल स्टार्टेड ऑन फर्स्ट व्हेन वी केम टू ह्यूस्टन. सो यू आर हियर सिंस यस्टरडे बट वी स्टार्टेड ऑन फर्स्ट सेकंड थर्ड. वी आर अहेड ऑफ यू. फर्स्ट सेकंड थर्ड फोर्थ, दिस इज द फोर्थ डे फॉर अस. दिस पर्टिकुलर टाइम वॉज अलॉटेड फॉर द lecture, but I feel that lecture is not necessary. Only thing is future vision of the organization. I'll just say in 5 minutes. Then we will go ahead with Tattvabodh Sadhana, Shanti Yog, Nadi Yog, and then the Prarthana, and then the Aarti. So afterwards, the children will go, group 1, 2, 3, will go to take their dinner, and we will go to dinner afterwards. Okay? You understood it, the whole schedule, Mamta Ben? Is there any change in this schedule? Ji? Is there anybody from? No change. Okay. So I have got 10 minutes now to tell you about the future vision of the organization. Shanti Kunj ka bhavishya kya hoga? Shanti Kunj ki bhavishya ki yojna hai kya hai? Let me tell you the vision which by the grace of Gurudev I have been endowed with. As you see, many people start feeling that the our work is Yuga Nirman, our work is Vichara Kranti, thought revolution, our work is not to help others. But Gurudev has said that Pida Nivaran, Suvidha Samvardhan and Patan Nivaran, these three are our sevas. We have to do all these sevas. You cannot imagine the gravity of the disaster which happened. You have seen Narendra Modi and you have seen Shivdas Singh Chauhan, MPs of Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh, just in that series. And you have seen various ministers speaking about the Gayatri Parivar and Shantipur. You won't imagine more than about 30 electronic channels, more than about 300 newspapers have covered for 10 days about our organization, whatever we have done. So you can imagine the people's response to Shanti Kunj, this effort. And whatever we have done is just service to humanity. Service to humanity is very important. This is particularly number one priority for us, that if Himalaya survives, we will survive. If Ganga survives, we will survive. So this is one reason that survival of Himalayas is very important. You won't imagine that more than 40,000 people have been swept away just by a flash flood. Flash flood has come here also. Katrina has come here also. New Orleans has suffered. And the Sandy came, but there was only suffering. Few people might have died, but the most important, most significant damage was to the electricity. That electricity was lost for 3 days, 2 days, there was no cooling. People wept about that, people cried about that, people shouted on the government about that, and then that was restored. But what about the loss of life? In front of the people, the relatives were swept away. You cannot imagine. I have been on news channel, I have been seeing news channel for about more than 12 to 15 hours for next 10-15 days. I was totally in touch. We had a satellite phone. We had our satellite phone in the remote area, and National Disaster Management Force was acting, and we were constantly in touch with IG, DIG, MP, the DMs, district magistrates, who were doing the Rahat Karya, who were doing the relief work. Relief, rescue and rehabilitation, these are the three things. The first stage has passed. Those who are being searched, that is the government's job. They are to be searched where they are exactly. Many people became, just they lost their mental balance. And many people said, we don't want to go because I saw my wife, my children being swept away in front of me. I don't want to go. Where will I go? My everything is lost. What will happen to your home? Let it go to people. I don't want it. I want to be in the lap of Himalayas. I want to die here only. This is the state of affair of the Uttarakhand tragedy. Uttarakhand tragedy is the worst tragedy in the last 200 years. You cannot imagine the law, number is not important that 40,000 people died and this. The 20 lakh, 2 million people have been displaced from their place. They used to live in houses, 10 houses, 12 houses, 15 houses, villages in the remote areas. Now their whole roji roti, you know, understand roji roti, their daily earning was dependent on the pilgrims. Pilgrims have gone. They interviewed pilgrims. They asked, will you like to come again if Badrinath is opened or Kedarnath is opened? Well, never in our life will come to this area because we are now totally, we are afraid of Himalayas. We are afraid of this thing. I think nature has punished them. I think we people thought that we will become resort in the river, we will come here and we'll have the same luxury which we have luxury in hotels or in various picnic areas or various mountains like Nainital, Mussoorie. So they made Nainital, Mussoorie in Badrinath, Kedarnath. What is this nonsense? So it is our mistake. It is whatever sins we have done, we have been punished for that. So Gayatri Parivar has done immense awareness program for that. Beta. Keep quiet. I'm talking something which you must listen because you have to work in future for that. Okay? So listen. If you want to go, you can go. But don't talk. Now, what has happened is, let us hope that it doesn't happen again. But now the loss has to be recovered. Secondly, we are giving houses. And these houses will be costing us 1.5 lakh. And already we are committed, there are various organizations which are coming up like Chamber of Commerce, FICCI, and Ambani's Trust, which is coming up. These people will definitely be a big boost to us. Yesterday only I received the mail that Dr. Saab kindly sent us a letter. I drafted the letter and sent it because of the lack of connectivity, there was a big problem, but I did it. I was eating and I was typing letter and everything, I was doing it. And it has reached, and we hope that lot of businessmen, lot of Chamber of Commerce people will be helping us to bring help to those people who lost their houses. We intend to make 2,000 houses right now. And model of the house, actually this CD was made a little bit earlier. It was made about a week earlier. Meantime, the model of house has come. So I don't have the model of house here in this, but I have got model of house in my iPad. Unfortunately, I cannot show it to you by projector, but I can tell you that it will be the most safe place, safe thing for them to live in. We will convince, we'll go to villages. There are about more than 2,000 villages which have been swept away. 2,000 villages need to be established. You will say it is government's job. Let government do it. Government is not going to do it. 17,000 crores means 1,70,000 rupees have been already given and nothing has been invested in the government. This is all corruption, all corrupt India. And this is because of that we are all worried about. If the money doesn't reach the people, I sometimes get very angry. And sometimes I fight with the ministers, I fight with the chief minister, I fight with the various people, and I say, if you are unable to extend this thing, give it to various organizations and let them do it. Monitor you. You monitor them, they help. Ultimately, this is the most important work which we have in priority. And because of this priority, I managed to come with the guidelines being given from here. Gigi and Chinmay are there. They are looking after the rehabilitation work. Besides that, we are going to open the schools in various areas. The schools have been totally swept away. We already have supplied to 200 schools. They are all basic needs. We have supplied dresses, uniforms, tables. If you remember, in India when you were there, the tat patti used to be given. Tat patti means the dari or patti on which you used to sit and you used to write down the slate. They are all, the whole thing has gone in the river. I have not seen the angry form of river earlier. This is the worst form of tragedy. So schools have to be rehabilitated. Hospitals need to be rehabilitated. Hospital has been supplied with the doctors plus equipments we are doing that. This is just like running a parallel government. This particular work which we are doing, just like running a parallel government. The moment I am back there in India, I'm not having any other program except to monitor all these efforts which we are doing. Our next movement is for you people. Today we talk to various organizations, the various areas in which the organization is working. And Naren Bhai Desai from Chicago, he monitored it very well. I want to train about 50 to 100 youngsters from my university, and I want to hire an immigration lawyer, and I want to send them here so that they can start working for you. They can start definitely disseminating the message. The youth and the matured people with them will definitely help you in erecting a structure here, infrastructure. There are already existing three centers. One in Midwest, that is Chicago. One in far west, that is the east western coast, that is LA, Anaheim. And one is in New Jersey, that is east coast. We want to have 3-4 more centers, and I think we'll be able to do that with the help of these people who will be donating the time. This is the next program which we have. The other program is the translation of the books. Translation of the books in English, very good English. Good English means not one in which you have to open the dictionary. One which is readable language, one which is understandable. If you read Vivekananda, you understand that this particular English is very good. This particular language, I want to let them be translated. About more than 500 titles we need to translate in next 2 years. This is Gyan Kranti Varsh, 150th anniversary of Swami Vivekananda. We want that Swami Vivekananda's work should continue. And how it should continue? Param Puja Gurudev came as the incarnation of Ramakrishna Paramahansa, and we want to extend this work to next 2014-2015. By 2015-2016, Shanti Kunj is aiming to spread the Gurudev's thoughts to about more than, now right now we are in about 100 million people. We want to reach to 500 million people. 500 million people, if we are able to reach 550 crore people, and the youngsters will be around half of that. That means 25 crore will be youngsters. If we have that much of proportion, the organization has that much of proportion, you won't imagine any people, any person, any great person, any political person, any organizational head you ask, they will all say, there may be a lot of money with other organizations, but there are only grassroots level people with Shanti Kunj. The only organization which can really revive Indian culture is Gayatri Parivar, is Shanti Kunj Haridwar. And if you are proud, if you are Gayatri Parivar person, you should be proud of these remarks, that we are able to cater to the demands and we are doing 24 hours work. There are volunteers. Average age of the organization is 27 years. The organizational workers, the average age, if you calculate from the top to bottom, few at the up level, around 10, 15, 20, 30 people are above 70. They are the senior people. They are the people who are guiding us. They are the people who sat at the full lotus feet of Gurudev. Then below that, you've got about 20 persons who are between 60 and 70. Then there are few people who are from 40 to 50. But most of the people, younger people, are coming to Shanti Kunj and they are settling down, and this is a good sign that the future of the organization is very bright. We should never be scared of what will happen to the future. Doctor will not survive for more than 20-25 years. I'm 63 right now. So I will be continuing till 63, 64, till 83, 84, 85. I don't know. It is up to Gurudev's wish. I cannot predict when I will leave my body, but I know that before leaving my body, I'll prepare a generation which can take the organization up to 2019, and then its responsibility is to take it further. This is what is the vision of, because everybody wants to know vision of the mission. The vision of the mission is to spread the various thoughts, like scientific spirituality thoughts. I want to start a separate magazine for that, for youngsters. I want to start separate magazine for Nari Jagran. I want to start separate magazine for Bal Sanskar Shalas. All these things will spread like anything, and by this we will be able to spread the organization of Gurudev's revolution, thought revolution movement, to the nook and corner of the whole world. I think this thing will definitely happen, because this is the Gurudev who is guiding us from the Himalayas. And if Himalayas are the sanctity of the Himalayas is maintained, and I think the Himalaya wanted, and that sanctity should be maintained. So throw these people out, throw these people out. Innocent people have died. It is a mass genocide because of the common punishment. Punishment is given to everybody, whosoever does it. It has happened, already it has happened. Now the time has come to do the repair work. The repair of the damage, repair of the hurting and of the feelings, and all these things they need to be done. All of you are invited to share with us your feelings, whatever you can do for the organization, whatever you can do for the Shanti Kunj activity. I have not come here to collect funds. I have not come here to collect money from you. I have come here to disseminate the message of Parampuja Gurudev. I come here to motivate youth, youngsters. I come here to strengthen the organization. I come here to tell you that here onwards, I may not be able to come, but I will not leave you alone. I will be sending people from there. You have to help me out. The senior people like Naren Bhai Desai, like Mahesh Bhatt, like Harendra Mangrola, like Natu Bhai Patel and Rauji Bhai, and like Bharat Taylor, Mamta Ben, and all of you, Mahesh Patel, all those in the south, all these people have to work out a strategy so that I may be able to send not only 50, but 500 Sanghmitras and 500 Mahendra of the son and daughter of Buddha, like people from India to this place. But that is up to you, whether you work it out or not. I got many workers in the field who may like to come and devote their time here, 6 months, 1 year, they will be able to do it. But that is up to you. You have to work it out. You have to work it out with the immigration people. You have to work it out with the other people so that we may be able to send. One toli coming, performing music, going away, it doesn't matter. It doesn't help at all. There should be sustenance. There should be perseverance of the work, good work being done. If good work is not continued, then nothing will happen. So I request all of you to search amongst yourself. Are you strong enough? Are you ready to train yourself? I'll be sending trainers. Training of the trainers will take place here in various centers, and training of the trainers, after the training of the trainers, those who are about plus 65, retired, or those who want to retire early, give your time for dissemination of Gurudev's knowledge. This is the right time. This time will never come. 2013 to 2026, this 12-year period, 12 to 13-year period, is very important, very crucial for all of us, for all of you. Because this is going to decide the destiny and the humanity. If Gayatri Parivar survives, Gayatri Parivar exists, Gayatri Parivar multiplies, the whole world will change. Definitely, the whole world will change, the whole world will be transformed. These 12, 13 years are very important, and all of you have to participate in it. Not only America, but whole world I am delivering this message. So please listen to my voice and listen to my understanding, and whatever I have been able to conceive upon, the thoughts which Gurudev has given to me, that you have to multiply, you have to multiply. Don't remain limited to yourself. Don't remain limited to just few kathas, few aartis and few these things. You have to bring youth in the field, and bring your youth in the field. Bring your son and daughter. My father donated me to Gurudev. I have donated my son to Gurudev. Why can't you donate your sons and daughter to Gurudev? Means Gurudev's work. For Gurudev's work, why don't you give some sacrifice? Why don't you give example of sacrifice for them? Let them work for the mission. I don't want full-time worker, but at least 15 days a month, or 15 days in 3 months, or 15 days in 6 months. Let them give some time. We will make a charter out of it, and we will try to schedule it in such a way that everything will be very well organized. I hope all of you agree with me. I hope you share my agony with you, and I hope you understand why I am so worried about the future. I am worried about the future because new people are not joining us. New people will join only when they see you prospering, building up, doing good work, sending sanskar to their children. They will grow up and they will come and join you. There is a tough competition. It's a very tough competition. Just like a corporate world competition, there's a tough competition in the religious field also. But we are much more advanced than them in the field of knowledge. Can we associate with the akin organization who are close to us? Can we help them and they can help us so we can multiply more faster? Bay Area and this particular Texas area, this Louisiana area, all these areas, they've got immense potential. You have to develop a strategy to work it out. I'll be helping you out from there, from Shantigunj. I'm available on the email ID pranav.pandya@gmail.com, and I try to answer, even if two lines or three lines, I try to answer each and every mail. You can go to the website and see the website, and you can be in touch with me as well as with the organization's various bodies. I'll strengthen the abroad cell after today's talk. What I come to conclusion, I'll strengthen the abroad cell the moment I reach. After the afternoon meeting, I have formulated the strategy for that, and I have written all those points within 15-20 minutes time, and I will keep on writing about that how to strengthen it, and then I'll implement it. I promise you, Gurudev and Mataji are behind all of you. They will take personal care of you. Your personal problems will be all taken care of. Don't worry about that. Even if you are unable to talk to me, your all personal problems. You do Gurudev's work, Gurudev will do your work. Tu mera kaam karega, main tera kaam karunga. Gurudev ne kaha hai. Tu mera kaam kar, main tera kaam karunga. Aap kariye to sahi, karke to dekhiye. Once you do it, you will definitely see that the things are coming to you. They are being showered on you. Your children are getting more and more intelligent. Your children are getting more sanskarvan. Your children are repaying back to you, and all these things will come back to you. Thank you very much. This is the only lecture which I have. Now, the evening is arriving and we are doing Tattva Bodh Sadhana. Just sit erect, put your hands in your lap,